स्टार्ट इन इट्स लाइसेंसिंग पॉलिसी गवर्नमेंट विल रेगुलेट दी एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द लार्ज हाउसेज टू ब्रिंग देम इन लाइन विद द कंट्रीज सोशियो इकोनॉमिक गोल्स वेयर लार्ज स्केल यूनिट्स वेदर बिलोंगिंग टू लार्ज हाउसेज और नॉट आर ऑलरेडी इंगेज्ड इन द मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ आइटम्स सिंस रिजर्व्ड फॉर द स्मॉल स्केल सेक्टर देयर विल बी नो एक्सपेंशन इन देयर कैपेसिटी ऑन द अदर हैंड द शेयर ऑफ दीज यूनिट्स इन द टोटल कैपेसिटी फॉर दीज आइटम्स विल बी स्टेडली reduced and that of small scale and cottage sector increased in licensing other activities of large scale industry particularly of units belonging to large houses government would pay due regard to the existing share of these units in the total domestic production of these items. It will be the policy of the government to ensure that no unit or business group acquires a dominant or monopolistic position in the market. The present industrial activities of the large houses will be scrutinized so that unfair practices arising out of manufacturing interlinkages are avoided. There will be an expanding role for the public sector in several fields. Not only will it be the producer of important and strategic goods of basic nature, but it will also be used effectively as a stabilizing force for maintaining essential supplies for the consumer. The public sector will be charged with the responsibility of encouraging the development of a wide range of ancillary industries and contribute to the growth of decentralized production by making available its expertise in technology and management to small scale and cottage industries sectors. The government would also like the society clarify its policy regarding foreign investment and foreign companies in India's industrial development so far as existing foreign companies are concerned. The provision of the Foreign Exchange Regulation Act would be strictly enforced after the process of dilution under this act has been completed. Companies with direct non-resident investment not exceeding 40% will be treated on par with Indian companies, except in cases especially notified, and their future expansion will be guided by the same principles as those applicable to Indian companies. The creation of a strong and diversified industrial economy does not mean that the country should not or need not participate in international trade, both as exporter and importer of industrial goods. In fact, the favorable changes that have taken place in our foreign exchange situation and the progress that we have made in the industrial field should now enable us to selectively dispense with import quotas and quantitative restrictions while retaining the protection given through tariffs. The government attaches great importance to balanced regional development of the entire country so that disparities in levels of development between different regions are progressively reduced. The government had decided that no more licenses should be issued to new industrial units in metropolitan cities having a population of more than 1 million and urban areas with a population of more than 5 lakhs as per the 2011 census. A sound price policy has to aim at a reasonable degree of price stability and a fair parity between prices of agricultural and industrial products. There has been a tendency to regulate prices of industrial products, which are vital to the needs of development, in a manner which made their production less attractive than production catering to the needs of the elite. It will be the policy of government to ensure that in cases where there is price control, the controlled price will include an adequate return to the investor. By the same token, government cannot permit exorbitant profits being made by industries which are operating well below their capacity or by units which operate in a monopolistic fashion. The most important single resources of any country is the skill, head, and hard work of its people. We in India have an abundant supply of labor, which is capable of acquiring new skills very quickly, and also an existing reserve of technical and managerial personnel. These resources can be used effectively only in an environment in which the workers and managers develop a sense of personal involvement in the working of the enterprise. Family control of business, particularly in the field of large-scale industries, is an anachronism, and it will be government's policy to insist on professionalism in management. The government are examining the possibilities of encouraging workers' participation in the equity of industrial units without in any way adversely affecting their interests. Such equity participation, together with an active association of workers in decision making from the shop floor level to the board level, will provide the necessary environment for a meaningful participation by workers in the management of industry. One of the disturbing features of the industrial scene in recent years has been the growing incidence of sickness of both large and small units.